Today I have 7 tricks or tips for using Adobe Illustrator when logo designing. So follow along and learn these 7 tips that are going to help you when you're designing logos in Adobe Illustrator. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Let's waste no more time and let's jump right into today's tutorial on 7 tips or tricks when designing a logo in Adobe Illustrator. The first logo design tip in Illustrator is about being organized. An organized designer is an efficient designer, and this tip will help you out for sure. When designing a logo in Illustrator with many objects or components, you might want to take a look at the layers window. If you assign a relevant name to each object as you design your logo, you'll be able to select specific areas with ease. To edit the name of a layer, simply double-click it and then go in and enter a name. In this instance, I'm changing a typo that I've made. So yeah, you can click each layer to highlight it and locate the specific object quickly. You can see how this trick will be useful for your logo design projects. There are also a few settings here, such as flattening the artwork and so forth. One absolutely huge trick or tip for logo designing Illustrator is to familiarize yourself with the keyboard shortcuts. Now, you can look on Google for a list of shortcuts, or you can search YouTube for tutorials such as mine, but I will name a few of the main ones you want to keep in mind for logo designing. If you press P, this will allow you to access the pen tool really quickly, and then if you press X, it will toggle between the stroke and the fill on the bottom left of your screen. If you then press Shift and X together, it's literally going to change the fill and the stroke, which is very handy indeed. So let's draw a shape really quickly with the pen tool, and then you can press A for the direct selection tool, and then V for the selection tool. And you can also use the Shift X shortcut that we mentioned just now, and the shape will alternate between a stroke and a fill. So there are a few shortcuts you want to keep in mind for logo designing. My point here is to familiarize yourself with all of the shortcuts, or as many as possible, when designing a logo in Illustrator. This next Illustrator tip or trick is one that I've mentioned a few times on this channel, but it helps you a lot of logo designing. You might not be a pen tool master, and if so, you can use the smooth tool here. However, you first must have the line or the object selected, and then locate the smooth tool. You then roughly draw the direction you wish to take the line, and Illustrator will smoothen the path like so. This is an amazing tool, especially for people who are just learning to use Illustrator and the basics. Here is a recent logo design that I created for a client. This next tip or trick in Illustrator will help you be precise and on point with your designs. You probably know that hitting Command or Control R is going to open up the rulers. And then once they're open, you can bring down guides that will help you align objects and be very precise. However, we can actually open an entire grid like so. Now you can design your logos with total precision. You have multiple lines and guides across the entire artboard to design and fit your artwork alongside. So in this instance here, I can change the logo type to be the exact same length as the logo symbol itself. Now I advise you guys to start designing your logos with the grid open from the get-go. It's a real awesome tool for logo designing in Illustrator. Thank you. The fifth tip for logo design in Illustrator is another built-in setting. If you head up to Illustrator Preferences at the top of your screen, and then you go and head to Smart Guides, you can see what settings that I'm using here. This basically will help you to be even more precise with your work and make your design life that much easier. If I now take objects with vector paths, magenta guides are going to appear when certain things are aligned, centered, and so forth. Of course, you can customize the settings for your own needs, but having at least some smart guides activated is a great idea for logo designing Illustrator. You may have several designs on several artboards, but with the asset tool, you can save them all at once as different designs. Simply open up the asset export window, and then drag and drop your designs into the window. But first, check out the different options that you have, such as saving for PNG and JPEG, and also presets for iOS and Android. Once you've dropped your designs in, hold down Shift and select multiple logo designs at once, and then click Export when ready. The default location for your logo design files should be Creative Cloud. And as you can see, all the logo designs here are saved as separate designs, which saves a whole lot of time. I love this logo design trick, as I often use it myself. The final tip for logo design Illustrator is a biggie. I know some designers who don't even use the pen tool for most logo designs. They only use this tool for creating the actual shapes. I have a collection of shapes here, and I've made sure that they perfectly align and meet smoothly at intersections. This is important, and you need to be precise when you work in this way for logo designing. If I then select everything, I can take the Shape Builder tool. By default, it has the plus icon above the cursor, which means we can join shapes together. And I will show you how that works now. If you then hold down the Alt Option key, a minus icon will appear, and this will minus certain areas of the design and remove them. If you've seen this tool before on this channel, I'm sorry, but this list of logo design tricks isn't complete without it included. Now I can add a fill to my final shape, which would have been a pain to create with the pen tool, or would have taken a longer time. Pressing Command or Control Z will take us back some steps. And now I can make a different shape, using both aspects of the Shape Builder tool. You can use the shortcuts from earlier in this tutorial to change the stroke to a fill, and then remove any unwanted areas. So that was my video on 7 tricks or tips when designing a logo in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video in the comment section below, and don't forget to leave a like on this video if you really did find it useful. Also, you can share my content on social media, which really does help out the channel. I've got more great content for you guys this week, so I hope you stay tuned for all of my videos coming up on Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. So, until next time, design your future today. Peace.